Travis will be here as we get into the latest on Colin Kaepernick's job prospects. But we start today with the Cardinals. If you believe the hype, Kliff Kingsbury and Kyler Murray are going to be football's Eric B. and Rakim. For those of you at home who are not rap music historians, Eric B. and Rakim dropped an album in 1987 that elevated and legitimized rap as an art form.
Classic.
It was called Paid in Full.
Ooh.
10 tracks from I Ain't No Joke to Move the Crowd to Eric B. as President.
Yeah.
All classics. To this day, Paid in Full is the rap gold standard. It changed the game.
Say that again.
Kingsbury and Kyler, or as I like to call them, KK, are supposed to change and elevate the NFL. They're supposed to legitimize the college spread gun offenses that keep turning Big 12 quarterbacks into Heisman Trophy winners and top draft picks. Hell, the Arizona Cardinals fired their rookie head coach and rookie quarterback from a year ago to make room for KK, two guys who came to fame in the Big 12 Conference. Kingsbury was the Doogie Howser of college coaches. He was 33 when he took over as head coach at Texas Tech and doubled down on Mike Leach's air raid offense. Kyler is the Mighty Mouse of sports, a relatively tiny two-sport superstar, a first-round pick in baseball and football. He won the Heisman at Oklahoma in his lone season on the gridiron. I bring all this up because last night, KK ran into some NFL turbulence. It was ugly. The Oakland Raiders throttled KK in a preseason game. In the first half, the Raiders outscored the Cardinals 26-0. Worse, Kyler completed just 3 of 8 passes for 12 yards. He was sacked twice. He fell backwards on one sack and gave up a safety. His collegiate pre-snap clapping motion drew 2 false start penalties, which is what made me think of Eric B. and Rakim. Make him clap to
make
this.
Make him clap to this.
The chorus for Eric B. is President. And so I'm like, Kingsbury and Kyler are going to take over the NFL the way Eric B. and Rakim took over the rap game in 1987? But they don't even know how to clap legally? It's not happening. There's too much resistance. NFL coaches don't like or respect Kliff Kingsbury and how he got this job. Who knows if Steve Wilkes was a good NFL head coach? What NFL coaches do know is it was highly unfair for Arizona to fire him after one season and then turn around and hire the only coach to fail at Texas Tech in the last 40 years. Raiders coach John Gruden is an NFL lifer. He's a major player in the NFL coaching fraternity. I don't think it was a coincidence the Raiders used an assortment of blitzes in an exhibition game. I think NFL coaches would like to see Kingsbury fail. They don't want to see college failures handed one of the 32 best coaching jobs in all of football. The NFL is a tight-knit group. Kingsbury's going to get hazed by everyone in the NFL fraternity. All last season, the refs flagged quarterbacks for false starts 8 times. Despite Kingsbury pleading with the head of officials during pregame warm-ups, Kyler was flagged twice. Kingsbury got hazed last night. Last year, Sean McVay's success had every NFL franchise looking for the next Sean McVay. That's part of the reason Kingsbury landed the Arizona job. If Kingsbury is successful, you'll see more pro teams look to the college ranks for their next head coach. And they won't even need to be a successful college coach. Kingsbury's NFL coaching peers can't let him move the crowd. Little Kyler Murray might end up collateral damage to the Kingsbury resistance. All right, joining the desk now are Fox Sports NFL analyst T.J. Housmanzada and the NFL Network's Bucky Brooks. Marcellus, start us off. Will Kingsbury and Kyler, will that combination work?
You know the answer to that. I mean, obviously, it's too early to tell, but I will give you some bullet points that we should emphasize. One, we need to all take a collective breath and remember, this was the worst team in football last year. Can we remember that?
Arizona or the Raiders?
Close. The worst team in football. That offensive line is porous, as they say. It's easy to
get sacks on it.
Boy, I come back, lose 10, and I can go get these against them boys. I mean, every game we've seen so far. Secondly, you talk about only 5 series of judgment. And we all laugh at the Pro Bowl when we see physically how guys give effort and it goes on the roller coaster. Let's talk about philosophy and let's talk about game plan in the preseason. When coach is telling you to try easy, and nothing is more difficult than going out there and trying easy. What does that mean? That means, look, we're trying physically, But you're going easy in terms of what the playbook looks like. We're very vanilla. And then a John Gruden, old school coach, every time I'm on the field, it's an opportunity, and he's under fire, he comes out with blitzes. And look, Kliff Kingsbury can respond with fire, but he's like, why? This is not the time or the place. Congratulations on your 0-0 record still. So I think this was just a perfect storm that went against them, but there's no time for judgment because it's still the preseason.
It's what you said. It's very early. If I'm going to answer the question, I'm going to say, yeah, the combination is going to work. I think Kyler Murray is he's that type of quarterback and that type of player where he's going to make it work. He's a winner. He's won at every level he's been at. The problem is, number one, they had the first pick for a reason. Offensive line is terrible. But if you say, name the top 40 receivers in the league, will you name any Arizona
Cardinals? Larry Fitzgerald's still there.
Stop you would that. Name him in the top 40 off of talent or off of name?
Don't do that.
Name. And
right.
Talent.
And so his best offensive weapon is David Johnson. They're being really vanilla. Like the first game, Kyler Murray had a pretty good game. Oh, he's really, it's the preseason. Nobody really game plans. Now you game plan. Oh, there's no game planning. That's a lie. You game plan. You just don't really go in depth with it as much as you would. Now, another point is that Arizona Cardinals defense is terrible. They couldn't stop a nosebleed. Mm. The Raiders just went up and down the field. So if they're stopping the Raiders here and there, it doesn't look as bad. Vance Joseph needs to get that unit on board and say, oh man, can we play a little better defense?
Look, when I watched this, I knew the incoming was gonna come, especially right after he called, Steve Keim, the general manager, called him a generational talent. Everyone is evaluating Kyler on everything that he does. But I believe last night's game was an indictment on Kliff Kingsbury. Kliff Kingsbury is the coach. When Kyler Murray is a rookie quarterback, his job is to go to the sideline and get answers from the coach. And it appears Kliff Kingsbury doesn't have answers. When they lined up and they mugged the gaps and did those double A-gap blitzes,
yeah,
and they're coming off the edges, at some point, Kliff Kingsbury has to change the protection. And if he doesn't have a couple of protections in his pocket, Kyler Murray is going to get hammered. And the indictment will be on Kliff Kingsbury and their air raid offense more so than the young quarterback.
Well, and that's my narrative on this from word go. I didn't like the Kingsbury hire. I think it's irritated the coaching fraternity. Rex Ryan was on ESPN this morning celebrating what happened last night and praying that it happens over and over again. You can't tell me the John Grudens and these lifetime NFL people are happy that some dude that failed at Texas Tech was handed one of the 32 best jobs in football. He's going to get everybody's A game. They can be a trash team again this year, and normally a good team would back off a little bit. I don't think head coaches are going to allow it because they want this dude to fail because they saw it last year with McVay, and that was fine. He's from the NFL, 32. But to see all those coaches get jobs because of Sean McVay, and if this dude has success, that's going to make it even more pronounced. They're going to put their foot down.
Another collective breath. Listen to what you just said.
What?
Okay, first of all, there's no such thing as hazing as a coach because I don't have to take all you coaches on at one time. I take you one at a time. Right. So you ever been in a locker room, been hazed? Ain't no one dude jumping on you. All of them come to get this. So it's not hazing. Let's get that out the way. Secondly, Coach A, you want to play me week one? How hard are you going to try? 100%. Oh, you want me to fail? Now how hard you gonna try? The same damn thing. So guess what? I'm not scared of you and your smoke. I understand. I agree with you. They don't want him to succeed, not just because he's gonna pull more unqualified. It's because their qualifications are going to start to get undermined. Unless you're a Super Bowl winning coach, y'all all suspect. It's kind of like in the real world with education. Oh, that bachelor's is cute now. You better keep going. If not, no one's going to care about it. So I agree with you, but there's no reason for him to feel anxiety or fear. You take them one at a time, and you're always going to get their best.
Well, my point is I don't think it's going to work. I think coaches are human beings just like players. I know you look at certain teams on the schedule and say, oh, my God. We throw our helmets out there.
And
again, Arizona's one of those teams, and I don't think anybody's going to allow that. Mm. I don't think coaches, again, they're just like players. They feel like, oh, man, we got one here. They're going to make sure that they get this dude, And I just think for a young quarterback like Kyler Murray to be the number one pick, he's a bit undersized. That offensive line, they're vulnerable. Their defense, the whole thing. And so once that starts happening and everybody keeps coming over to the sidelines, like Bucky said, and there's no answers, this thing's going to go sideways and off the rails. The Arizona organization, to me, be based on what they did to Steve Wilks and Josh Rosen, they're under a gun that I think is going to smother this.
The coaching staff and the players know what type of game planning is going on in the preseason. They know. So we can talk and say, oh, man, Kingsbury knows, okay, we're being real vanilla. His only advantage right here is the first couple games, nobody knows what he's going to do. That's his advantage, and so he needs to keep that advantage.
Right.
So he's going to be as vanilla as he can right now. The first game he'll have, and if they don't really know, they can go watch Texas Tech. They can go watch the preseason. Be vanilla as possible because the first two games are what matter, and I need to have that element of surprise going into those two games, so I'm going to keep things under wrap.
I hear you talking about keeping it under wraps, but at some point, if you got the number one overall pick, you got your number one quarterback, the guy that's going to be your starter, you would think you would like to protect him. You would think that you'd like to build up his confidence, especially as we're heading into the next week, which is week three, which is viewed as the final dress rehearsal. If I'm a starter rookie quarterback, I'm doing everything in my power to make sure that he enters the regular season confident and ready to go. You can't get him knocked around. And what we saw last night from the Raiders, they were bringing them dogs at him.
Yeah.
He didn't have any answers.
But that's unfair. Like, I mean, we should be looking at Gruden like, you're doing way too much.
I mean, it's right? Dirty. He's a dirty pool.
Yeah,
I mean,
it's dirty pool. Thing. It's the same thing when the Cleveland Browns come out in no huddle. We alert them. We're going to run no huddle to start the game.
Right.
And so very similar, like, oh, we're going to blitz you. It could be what you said. We're going to blitz you. Have an answer for this Mike Zimmer double A-gap blitz.
Yeah. I mean, I got been in the Pro Bowl before. I remember the first series of the Pro Bowl. Ran around Chris.